I showed up after I had waited at the bridge last night. Signs of him now. I hope he's okay. Dead. I don't last that long without proper care anyway. I've actually taken a look at all the stuff that was left behind in these rooms. Probably from old members. Judging by whatever these are. Maybe a writer left the ink thing behind. Took the quill. They aren't using it anymore. Might as well write in it. Big of what I can only assume is a rib cage.
On payment right now, and perhaps.
Morning.
Good morning.
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 No, you're back. How was the trip back?
Good. Don't see
flower. Others arrive.
I hope you don't mind.
Well, that's quite alright. I prefer it a little sweet. I can't really taste many things unless it is strongly flavored anyway. But the heat is always appreciated.
Is this seat taken?
It is not.
If they have an issue, then I can.
Well, I'm not sure about the flower, but.
I shall take a seat myself.
They're probably still.
I haven't seen them yet this morning.
I haven't seen them yet, no.
And I'll provide you.
Hiya.
However. Oh, sure. Greetings, Detective Wolf Paul. Your name? As I'm paying you preemptively.
Well, will your friend be joining us this morning?
Unfortunately not. I haven't seen him in a day, so I don't know where he is.
Does he come and go often? On his own?
Not for this long. I'm sure he's fine.
You know? Well, I'm sure he's doing just fine wherever he is.
He seems very capable. Alto.
You seem a little sad. Do you miss him?
They're from the academy. Yeah, of course. I'll get over it. You were gone for a while. Were you off on a mission or something?
I was checking some boats out. Not too far from here. I got back late last night.
I see. Were you looking to buy one or just looking?
Pleasure to meet you.
Well,
I know some knowledge of the powerful thing. This is a.
I have been tempted, but I'm afraid that if I were to go back to sea, I may be branded a pirate, unaccounting of my last interaction.
Ah, so you went to the academy.
I
had a misunderstanding. They branded me a pirate.
Oh, quite literally. Okay, alright.
Yes. Well, I'm not too proud of it, but you ought to know at least. I am no outlaw, of course.
I would be surprised
to be able to overturn the conviction.
Well, the branding is more of my concern. It's not so easy to overturn a literal branding.
Gloves. They do want
well,
that
they do.
You got your new hand.
Your new hand.
We could get her a new hand.
Well, this one is just fine. Thank you very much, Jenny.
I'm sure everyone can introduce you. That you don't, then well, kitchen area is over there.
Well, we could. If you change your mind, let me know. We'll make you a new hand.
I mean, we do have a member whose hands are made entirely of ice.
Yes.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yeah, but,
she's gone.
Well. Unfortunately, that would still not overturn my conviction. I would have
to
fit
her
under a false name.
Well, I hope you find.
We'll get you a new hat. That'd be great.
I like my hat.
Okay, well, fair.
Listen, I am not going to resort to anything that might further brand me as an outlaw. I'm innocent, and I'm sure those facts will bear out in time. Until then, I shall work away my time here.
Good morning, folks. Good morning. Good morning, folks.
Excuse me.
Good morning.
Hi. Hi.
Oh,
Spackmon.
Good morning, folks.
Hey.
What? What is he doing?
I don't know.
Not sure.
What?
Good morning, folks.
Good morning, Doug. Do you mind the jive boar?
Good morning.
Is he being suspicious?
Akume had dragged him.
He is enunciating his words a little clearer than usual. Which is in and of itself maybe a little suspicious.
Yeah, but like for things like hunting?
Have you seen Gabi?
Have you seen Gabi?
Have you been making use of the library?
Gabi.
Have you been making use of the library?
Correct.
You have a face.
I do have a face, yes, but I wear a mask.
Very good detention spot.
You have a face too, Gabi. Yeah, well.
Oh god.
I had hope that perhaps
yes, you is a very
he may have been somewhat enlightened
handsome.
By the books, but I suppose not.
Maybe one day.
Good morning.
I appreciate the
offer. Here, have a bottle.
Oh. Oh, thank you.
When are we gonna kill those bandits?
A good marvel.
Yes, while you were away, we had bandit problems. A few, causing trouble at the local tavern, and then I believe there was a skirmish between ourselves and them just the other day.
Yes, some of them are locked in the in the town in the
previous day from my reports of slight torture.
Is it their custom to hang bandits here?
Good morning, y'all.
I'm not entirely sure. There is a
there will be
gallows for that.
Well,
unfortunately, I did not see it.
There are ships in the harbor.
I will reach once we understand the situation and see if they are able to realize that
they're trying to hang people on ships.
Nevertheless,
well,
they are
yes.
not to be killed.
Yeah.
Rotund. Yeah. What for?
They are dangerous, you know.
Am I understood? Easily.
Like any crime? Like
what, Rotund?
Well, not quite.
Wonderful.
More like serious crimes.
We are not judge, jury, and executioner. We are guilty.
There isn't really a place for prisoners on board a ship. Not on that's been made for such things.
That's true. But
the more you talk about the boats, the less I want to be on them, if I'm perfectly honest.
I did not mean to besmirch the romanticism of shipping teams. I will say, in truth, it's often dreadfully boring.
They will get rotten.
That's a good plan.
Within 10 minutes' time, I will be making an announcement regarding the mission and who will be working on that mission.
Don't you
I would ask that you are outside.
Have, like,
you
some soup over there.
Tell
it is a nice soup, yeah.
No, the boar is dead.
Get some meat in that
now
stomach.
Now it needs to be prepared to be eaten.
Outside or outside?
And it's very good. I don't think we're going to
be that's outside, outside.
Oh, are we, sorry.
Inside, outside.
No, outside,
outside.
You can try this.
I don't...
You have to get through a building
confused.
To get to that in that outside, so it's outside
but
inside.
But still in building, still just roof. I don't.
That's
like
why
arena.
It's inside. That's why it's outside inside. Because it's not really outside, but it's not really inside.
Oh.
Ophelia?
Hmm?
You wouldn't happen to know Ozul's favorite food, would you? He seemed a bit stumped by the question before.
Not really. He doesn't really show preferences for anything. Recently, he's really liked the fish that Kai sells, but that's about it.
Then that's what I will buy. He was very helpful the other day, up in the mountains. Quite frankly, I'm not sure where I would be if he hadn't shown up, so I would like to thank him. Thank you.
Actually, have you seen him around at all in the past, like, 2 days? Like, in the town or anything?
I not. I sort of assume that he's always with you, and that you always know where he is.
Alright.
He's not here.
Last night he went... followed someone that ran into the Vale. And he hasn't come back.
Sure.
It's about the sword I was working on.
I was just curious because I know you were one of the second to last people he was with.
No, I was curious about the one with the red hair. She ate quite a lot for breakfast.
No, I haven't seen him since the mountains, since he ran off to find you.
Okay. Thank you anyway.
When would that ever happen?
No, she came in with the travelers. Some of them were.
Ah, see.
The log looks like
with the academy group.
Hello, Miss Anna.
Yeah. Most fun, morning, you know. I mean, she would know. You know yeah.
I was thinking.
Hi.
But you want to learn how to fly, and I can't teach you yet. However, I want to learn how to make
potions. Yes, ma'am. Of course.
Perhaps we could do a trade.
I have to. That's my big car.
My apprentice?
Oh, thank you for anything stronger than good.
Good morning.
I know it
is. How are you?
Morning.
Good morning.
Yes, I heard you had some trouble with some bandits.
Yes, we had a little bit of a run-in with some just a couple of days ago. They made their way into town and were harassing people inside of the Dreamcatcher just a while ago. They came in like they owned the place. Apparently, they were pretty confident.
How did you keep him?
relaxed.
What kind of crap?
But I'm still sick.
Well, for the most part, as far as the town went, it started off as just general debauchery, throwing stuff everywhere, and
I'm gonna go for it.
Being a
debauchery, I think. Unruliness, actually.
Yeah.
Breaking
yes,
the
yes.
peace and the like.
I stepped over the line when one of the townsfolk
ended up on the floor,
thrown in through the bar door, badly beaten. He was treated here, of course.
Well, maybe not just you. He doesn't seem to think that we're he's
covered in his own blood.
He shouldn't be on his own.
Well, not just yet, actually. We actually have them in custody, and we're looking to see about it that they're reformed.
I simply do not understand the local customs very well, and I wasn't sure if it was an appropriate remedy for this kind of interaction.
Oh, that's so
I'm not looking to take lives of the void here, but for the moment being, we're going to give them a little bit of a chance at redemption. Of the bandits, they seem to be new enough and I guess young and rough enough that I think that they're just two people that were in with the wrong crowd. Hopefully they
want
to sit themselves straight.
Two folks on the wrong path.
As far as I put it forward, me and Zogbell talked about it a little earlier.
Who's gonna be your apprentice?
Is that all right?
Hello again.
Hi.
Bandit camp. Yeah, the bandit camp.
How are you?
I'm alright. How are you?
Bandit camp.
They seem to
up good.
Maybe.
Yeah, they
it's good. Sell any more marbles?
Part of a bigger, yeah.
Not yet.
Some kind of bigger organization by the sounds of it.
You want a marble?
Numbers by what they were spouting.
No, it's alright. I bought one already.
Make me think that they got a little bit more than your common rate. They made threats at least, so that's already something that we have to mobilize again.
Here, have another.
But don't you want money for them?
Here we go.
We'll be assigned to send forth a small party of six to take a look. And if need be, dispatch the members. See to it that they scatter or
thank you.
Where to even begin? Because
you know, I think there's someone new here who hasn't bought a marble yet. I don't know her name, but she's got pink hair with a blue streak in it. I think she went that way.
I got my hunch about me, and this is sitting straight with me.
That's already more than
looking on having some people, some guild members, do a little bit of a tour around town for these folks that we got. Right, see if they can butter them up, then we can get some information to help our scouting party with. They're over in our dungeon, over in the, waiting to hear back from us. I don't know what's going on, so hopefully they'll, just
what
corner.
Kind of information are you looking for?
Oh my gosh.
We're hoping that they'll give us a little bit of a lead on where exactly they're based and the nature of their leader.
I
don't like the look of a leader that's been sent before. Basically, threaten an entire town. Leaf's side's small, but you've still got a good amount of people with it. And regular bandits aren't the ones that usually make a claim like that unless they have the force to act like it.
Well, I did once face a similar conundrum. I had to find out where some ruffian's ship was.
I am the knight.
And it was quite hard to tell what ship he was from. And so we let him escape. Follow him to his ship. And once he had positively identified the ship, we were able to capture it.
Is this where Shiny kept?
Claim the prize.
Aye. Yeah, well, yeah.
Alright, gonna put you down, but you behave.
Oh,
like
wait.
That
I'm not
baby.
Sure.
Let's go.
Oh, a giant.
Oh, Miss Ophelia.
Good morning.
I can splash him with water if you want. I brought a bucket. That you were also
have I already did it. I already did it.
Meantime, everyone,
okay.
The tank. Execute it.
Is everyone fine?
Yes, listen. Technically, it's a potion.
Sorry.
Technically, it's a potion. Technically, it's a potion to shine.
You don't need to worry.
Getting like this on purpose.
Just ensure that he doesn't fall over. That's all I ask.
Right. And you're now sitting behind him, so if he falls over, at least.
Majority of everyone. Yeah.
Just dealing with myself.
Right. So. As you are all aware, we have a mission that has been posted. This mission, I'm sure you are all quite acquainted with the two bandits rolling into town and making quite a ruckus. And so the select group of people have been selected to go and deal with this issue. In apprehension, not murder. Murder is a only absolute in the case of self-defense. Make that absolutely clear. In any case, regarding the mission, those that will be going are as follows. Gail, Flora, Kaleem, Gabi, Ophelia, and Ozul. And in the case that someone is not present, or they are under the weather, Jenny, you will be chosen as a backup.
Okay.
I encourage you all to take this time to prepare in whatever needs to make you fit. Training, supplies, whatever is your choice.
I hope he comes back in time.
That is all from me. Have you anything to add, Wolfric?
I would suggest, if you all are willing and able to, in about 5 minutes or so, after you have a little bit of a talk amongst yourself, to meet me over on the training grounds for a moment or two. Won't be too much of your time. I'd like to go over some things just to have everyone on the same page. A little bit of guidance just to set you on your way. Make this nice and easy for you so you can focus on the mission at hand. Other than that, that's all I got.
Yes, Marcel. What is your question?
What are we gonna do about the people that we beat up the other day and put
in those that we currently have in captivity? They are to be watched. If anyone is available and they are not currently busy or have a spare time in the day to watch over them, ensure that they aren't causing a ruckus, and certainly not kill them, then please stop by and check on them. They are still human. They are still people. Yes, later.
I'm not in the right aspect.
Yeah, Guildmaster, do you wish for everyone to come over to the training grounds?
No, you're not.
Just
the people announced for the mission.
I see.
Yes. Those specifically announced, please make your way along with Wolfric to train. Of course, anyone else is also invited to do so, but it is not necessary.
You're going, I'm going too.
However, we do ask that you, regarding back to the business, it is asked that some people do periodically take observation and make sure they are in good health, to say at least. Granted, they have caused issues for this town, but they are still people. Need to be judged properly and under proper law. Yes, Belina.
I can take the first watch.
Good. Wonderful.
Will you fit?
Well, I believe that sorts everything.
I could take the night watch.
Alright. Good. Is there any other volunteers? Alright, Marcel, you can watch in any other times that are available. Perhaps when you are a bit of more sound mind.
I'm good.
that is everything. Seems like it. Good, and I shall not keep you. You're all dismissed.
Training grounds.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Gabby. Well, seeing as how you're going on this and all, I'll be remiss in not giving you at least some basic insight.
I don't know how to deal with the situation right now.
Damn, Sue. Damn, Felian walks fast for a fat
right.
Bitch.
No problem with that.
You probably shouldn't call her fat.
I mean, she's there herself. She's heavy.
I swear, I don't know how I forgot the, like, 3-4 hours of work that me and Zog and the rest of them set up moving the training grounds, but I totally forgot.
You know, directions are funny sometimes.
In the case, my back sure doesn't forget. Ophelia, your buddy Ozul sleeping? Does he sleep?
He left a few days ago and I don't know where he is. I'm sure he'll be back.
Oh, wait. Now I'm ready.
Alright, there we go.
Would you like me to replace Ozul for today?
How do you mean?
Well, I thought you two ought together.
Yeah, we are, but I think I'm just a bit confused.
Well, I came here to watch, but just watching seems a little boring.
I don't see why not. If he makes us do training, then sure.
things that could work for double team.
Hmm. Alright. I'd be interested to see. Hello, I don't think we've met.
No, Melody.
Friend from the Academy.
Ophelia. It's a pleasure. Oh, you're from the Academy.
Yeah.
Alright, I see. Did you...
Late arrival.
Ah, okay. I see.
Welcome, welcome.
Hi.
I'm Jenny Pepper. Are you alright? Jenny. Short for Genevieve. Genevieve is an old woman's name. Melody. It's nice to meet you, Melody.
Oh, yeah. A Captain Sextet, not familiar.
Yeah. I've seen air pirates do that before.
I'm okay.
Kinda need to.
We're loading, though.
Which one? Yeah, I'm not gonna be reloading it in a fight. I'm probably gonna take a shot, put it away.
Well, hopefully when he's more sober, he'll not think you're an illusion.
Or he's a hunting. Could be really good for hunting.
Or maybe he's just being a jerk. He does that.
Hard to stab.
He does do that.
Yes.
No,
alright, so, looks like this is a good number of people, including quite a few extras, so, if y'all don't mind, those of you on the mission, anyone that's not here, give them a little bit of handy guidance.
Flora's gonna come in a bit, yeah.
Alright, she's gonna like a couple minutes.
Yeah, she had to go sort some stuff out.
Sorry, I keep pulling it up, by the way, if we're a habit.
Just for everyone here, though, the purpose of this is mainly just to, like I said before, get you all on the same page in terms of what we're doing and give everyone a little bit of leeway on some good practices for dealing with, I guess you would say, roadmen like this. Also some stuff that personally I need you all to keep in mind on this. Might just be based on a hunch, but hunches have kept me alive for... So sometimes you gotta go with your instinct. I'll explain that in a bit when everyone's here. For the most part, everyone should know each other, so that's already one step done. I think Melody's been introducing themselves to everyone just fine.
May I ask?
Yeah.
Is it a camp of these bandits being raided?
Well, the mission's objective is to act upon all the knowledge that we have about the camp, yes. We've already got some hints and things in that, but we're hoping that our people that we got in town will be buttered up a little bit. Give us a little bit more of a lead.
I would suggest you have quick-footed people to go and scout, as it may they may be hiding to ambush. I assume they'd be concerned about the two people that didn't come back.
Yeah, we've been thinking about it a long, hard while, and we'll set everyone up with all the precautions we can.
Not sure I'd be good for scouting. My magic is really loud and not good with the sword. Enough
that they'll be able to go with the flow as it is, even if something goes wrong. Mission itself sounds simple in theory. It's finding abandoned camp and dispersing it, if possible, but mostly garnering any information you can as the main objective. But then in comes the difficulties.
I'm here.
There we go. More people.
30 for today.
No problem.
If let's suit me.
I'll be out with that way.
Right. We don't got any more stragglers, do we? Doesn't look like it. He's already accounted for. Ozul will be back. Looks like we're good to go. Right.
Maybe. I hope. So, he'll be fine. Yeah, he'll be fine. He's capable.
As things go. Main objectives of the missions you saw on the board. We need to figure out as much information about the operation as possible and make decisions based on that. The main objective is going to require, as you might have guessed, a little bit more than running and gunning, as the saying goes. If our objective was only to take out the bandits, then it'd be pretty simple and straightforward. We're in a little bit of a spot, though. Me and Zogbell had a hunch over the course of the last day or so that everything seems to be falling in place with something a little bit concerning. As all of you probably were either a part of or heard about through your peers, we're dealing with a band of brigands that are fully capable of being confident enough to attack a small town. And whilst Leafside isn't exactly Drakaya or some big old fortress, you still gotta have the means to take care of, wrangle, and overcome an entire population of people, and one that, even after they found out the guild was here, well, confidence is an understatement at that point. We're a new foundation in this location, but the guild itself has been around for, you know, a good amount of time, over in the home location, deeper into the mainland. Rest assured, they knew a little bit about what we were. The new people that we got in town probably don't, but sure do now. So, what I want to go over real quick is to make sure that we all brush up on our bandit etiquette, as it were. Who here has experience fighting people? Humans, not just beasts. Right? So that's already a good amount of breath that we got. As you all know, dealing with people, especially people in a dangerous situation, is, well, it's something else. With an animal, you can predict that they'll make their way down into their most dire direct instincts, defend themselves with all they got. Humans will, in theory, in simple terms, do the same, but you're dealing with a person that has just as much edge, just as many options as you do. Many of these bandits probably don't come from very good places. Many of them probably are here doing the best they can with what they got. Others probably have people that inducted them in. Maybe they know a couple of people that were inside of the bandit's little posse already. Others may have something to prove and need a ragtag group of people outside of the law that they can basically use to test because they couldn't find it where they lived. And others might have other goals entirely. Something higher than only being part of this for a little while is what they need to achieve, whatever that is. When you deal with these bandits, know that you are dealing with other people that have their own goals. You're outsiders. Try and appeal to their humanity. Don't come to them immediately as just faceless people come in and take their lives. Not immediately. It'll be tough, and you'll have to improvise, but we picked you guys because we think, from what we know of you all so far, that you'll do a good job. You either have enough experience dealing with these bandits already that personal touch will be of use, or you have an edge, that of which we've recognized so far from your transcripts from witches, that we think will give us a little bit to work off of. In the best terms of everything, you walk out there with them intimidated or convinced enough that they don't mess with us and all the information you could want. Worst case scenario, you'll have to defend yourself from whatever is trying to take your life or whoever is trying to put you on the ground. This isn't a slaughter fest, folks. Don't take lives that don't need to be taken. But if someone comes for you, or one of your friends, you need to act, and you need to act fast. The moment that blades are drawn and they are swung at you or one of your peers, one of your comrades, that's a declaration that person is making, that they're forfeiting their rights, their freedoms to that peace, that mercy, and now it's combat. We need some information. Spelling it out as simply and as bullet point as possible, we need to figure out where these guys are operating from. That's one of the objectives. If the camp, or at least the area that we think the camp to be, so far, turns out to be their main camp, then that's useful information. If they give an inkling that there's another location, we need to know that. We need you guys to have eyes on all the bandits you can, and find out who calls the shots around there. They're going to be the person that'll be most important to figure out their mindset, what exactly they're doing. The third objective is to take a little bit of a measure of your area around you. We need to know why exactly these guys are getting in our business and why they feel so confident about doing that. Are they well armed? Do they have something of a mage about them? Do they have anything like that of which is making them confident enough that they feel the need to call pot shots on really anyone that, you know, picks them off? These three objectives are the most integral ones that you guys are going to be able to solve for us by the end of the day. Combat or not, day or shine, we need these answered. Hopefully, Celine and Anna are getting us a little bit more to work off of. Maybe we might even answer one of those questions by the end of the day. We'll have to wait and see on that. Now, about my hunch. Why I'm treating this so seriously is because of the observations I've made. I've fought many a bandits. I've seen many a group of rapscallions. These guys are... well, they're both reckless and organized. They're hiring up what seems to be a good amount of youngins. People around our age range here in front of me. People from various different walks of life. Talked a little bit to the two that we had in custody, and well, they're, by the standards of you folk, still fairly wet under the ears in comparison to combat ability. That's why on that night, when there was that excursion, they had to bring in a little bit of muscle. They're part of a group that of which is telling them that they're forced not to be reckoned with. I have sources and also a little bit of research that I did on my own, right? And something is not enough. We have not had too much in terms of knowledge of this particular band here. And it seems as if that there's also a little bit of talk that potentially it's not just one motive, one group of people that's behind it. Now, people cooperating isn't anything that of which is completely unheard of, but when you talk about brigands, it's a problem. When you get a group of people as chaotic as a group of bandits to work together, usually a higher goal is in mind. Bigger rewards, bigger plunders. Basically, I'm trying to read the wall, and so far I got that they've tested the waters leaf side so far, and the last thing I need is for everyone here to be blindsided with a force that we don't know the full extent of. That's why it's important you guys find out the information that you find. And him if it hurts, if need be. So everyone that's going on the mission, please remember those three things that we need. Make sure to watch each other, and I would recommend that you all take the time to practice with each other. Know as much about each other's abilities as you can, or at least as much as will make you all effective comrades. And probably get a little bit of organization around you. Pick one or two people to lead the efforts, make decisions when things get chaotic. Another person or two, that of which are good at talking. Make sure to have a dedicated focus to keeping each other wary and aware of your surroundings. And operate as much of the team as possible. If everything goes according to plan, you'll be in enemy territory, and the last thing is we need is for you guys to end up straggling or getting separated. With all that being said, lecture is done, briefing is done. All there is to do is for you guys to get to it. Any questions? Alright, pretty cut and clear, good. If you need anything, training, advice, anything like that, I will be around at the guild hall or in town. Don't really go too many places right now. Other than that, you're all dismissed.
Gotcha.
Take the precautions necessary and let's make sure everyone gets home. I'm gonna head back to the hall.
Understood.
Alright, first things first. I kinda befriended one of the bandits already. I'm not sure if that's useful or not.
That's interesting.
You befriended one of them?
Yep.
Nice to meet you.
Huh.
Alright.
Gabi broke her finger. I healed. We started talking. We became kind of friends. We're friendly.
Interesting. Alright. Yeah, it's, I honestly didn't expect
Gavi's
that.
Gavi's
so...
I can
you
be
as,
listen, I'm good with talking.
Hi, Herbalib.
Yeah, I was just about to say, having you as the designated talker and charismatic one is probably a good idea. I don't think I would be very good at talking with bandits.
I'll talk to bandits.
They may be doing shitty stuff, but honestly, if I was in their shoes, I would probably be doing the same. As other people have no choice. I knew, because I also did not have choice back in the day.
There's always a choice. Whether or not to hurt people who don't deserve it.
And you survived was on the line.
Apologies. Nobody forced them to beat up Kai.
Magically gifted. I wish to put in one small input. You may need to rely more on your physical strength, as unless you are absolutely sure you can control your magic. You not know what
I can help
reaction could be caused. Train. Good. Nakame, if anyone chooses to use their magic, he will help you. As will I if you need to seek me out. But what I will say is to not exactly refrain from magical use, but be very cautious. Remember your objectives. That is not the final answer. It is only a consequence of what they choose to do.
Yes, sir.
Good. Did not mean to intrude. Yeah. Continue your conversation.
Ah, yes. I'm good for talking with bandits, at least. I may not be fancy, but I am pathetic, at least. I know you're angry about Kai, but let's not get those feelings into this right now, right? We need to have a clear head.
Yeah.
This is pathetic? This doesn't look pathetic.
No, she's not.
Empathetic. I'm empathy.
Now, when it comes to leadership in combat,
don't trust me with that.
Yeah, I can handle that. Unless somebody else is comfortable doing that.
Flying.
Yes.
I'm sorry, what was that?
Helene is going with us.
Hi.
I'm glad you two became good friends.
Horrible. Yeah. Yeah, that's usually how most of these things go. Either work well or go horrible.
Gabby.
Hi.
You're really good with intimidation, but let's try to not break the fingers, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, torture is a little...
Or balls.
It's not good.
It's not the best.
If we've captured somebody...
I was told no more ball busting.
Yeah, no more ball torture.
If we have somebody captured, please don't torture them.
Okay.
So, a quick go over. What can everyone do combat wise here? So
let's start with Jeannie and go. Rotation.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the rotation.
I can sort of throw out some lightning, and I can channel it through my hammer as well, and sort of a big burst around me. I can also toss myself around with air a lot, or a bit, but that's not, you know, the most helpful.
Mm-hmm. Rez?
Rez? Rez is not...
Rez is here to say go, go.
That's not in the mission.
Okay.
Harass.
Yeah, I might not be going at all, so like, don't count on me. But you know, right. I'm just here in case.
Excuse me, I'm
probably going.
Can I borrow Gabi for a moment?
Yeah.
Sure. A goblin.
I'm back.
Okay. All right.
Come along, Gabi.
Hey.
You can go along with us if you want, since you're here for Gobby.
I stay and watch.
Yeah. Alright. Well, besides brute strength, I can do my big fuck off shield that I can shoot you guys and also drown anyone that I do not want inside of it. Tiny shields around my hands that I can also drown people. But use just like, you know, as a barrier or sort. I'm practicing a water hammer because all these things are very tiny for me. But it's still not ready to use, so I'm probably not gonna use it.
No, yeah, very useful. Especially the big shield. Imagine if they start shooting us with bows or something, that could be really, really helpful, honestly. Also, it's a good way place to fall back if we're we get in big trouble.
I've got a sword, I don't know how to use it, but I do a lot of ranged lightning stuff, but it's quite loud.
I saw it, it's really cool.
Thank you.
It is. I am a... I didn't think Aku was going.
I'm not going.
Oh, he's not going to the mission.
Alright. As I was saying, I am an expert swordsman. I have magic that is primarily long range. I have a short range spell that is just, like, can fill that, basically that whole room there, as well as a very long range bombardment spell. Other than that, yeah, my main focus is going to be swordsmanship, it looks like. So that's, and Gabi's also coming, and does anybody know what his skills
Gabi
are?
Gabi can do marbles.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was about to say, aside from just having marbles.
That tiny little goblin can fight like a savage.
Go, Gabi.
I don't think you saw him talking to the bandits, but it was fucking scary.
No, I definitely didn't.
Yeah, he talked to the bandits. And when we captured some of them.
Oh, this was very scary.
Not only that, he managed to say some very hurtful things, like he went right to the fucking heart.
Would anyone have something specific they'd like to train on?
I mean, not specifically. I probably need to practice with my gun a bit more. I'm not a great shot. And I don't want to burn through too much mana before we go. Targets. I don't want to, like, shoot you.
You feels already know I can defend myself.
Yeah, I still don't feel comfortable shooting somebody that I actually like.
Would you like some help with the blade?
Yeah, I was just about to ask about that.
Well, I could help that, unless... Gail...
No, yeah. Feel free.
Well then. So, come along.
Okay.
I'm
show me what you can do.
You want me to just, like, attack you, or...?
Yes, show me what you know.
Okay. That's about it. Just swing and stuff.
Swings need more strength behind them, and also, well, this appears to be a blade for very specific strikes. I'd say something such as...
So more angled instead of...
More angled, yes.
Okay.
And remember, your blade is not your only weapon. You can throw a kick, throw a punch, or even shoot magic.
Yeah, I usually rely on my magic. I'm not gonna use it here.
Do not worry about using. You can. I'm going to get ready for it. Oh, and please do not be afraid.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Intimidating.
Better. Now again.
Okay.
Make sure to not repeat the same patterns. Keep the patterns different so that your opponent won't know what you're doing.
Okay.
And remember, you can always throw your magic. As long as I stop it with my arm, I can.
I might refrain from any of my ranged stuff anyway, because there's people.
Of course.
All right. Do you ready? Okay.
Be careful, as your opponent can strike back at any time.
Right.
You don't know what your opponent is capable of, or what kind of weapon they may be hiding. I'm going to show you. First of all, depending on how your opponent is coming at you, remember to block everything the best you possibly can. Now, I'm going to give it a try. All I'll right. start slow. Now I'll swing a little faster.
All right.
Still not fast enough, but fast.
This isn't good. So bad, I guess.
Right. Now I'm going to try to actually hit. I'll keep the same pattern, up, right, up, left, above. Ready?
Yeah.
If you feel like you're being overpowered, dodge or use magic or any other ability such as a kick or dodging.
Okay.
Good. Now let's try to actually attack each other. We can start. Ready?
Yeah. Okay.
Go. Crap.
Oh no. Okay.
Now, what would you do in this situation? I have grabbed the hilt of your sword.
Dr. Cute.
Okay. Good. Now, some enemies may be stronger than others. Maybe your ability won't be enough for them to stop their attack. Try again.
Okay. Okay, no. Sorry, just...
Oh. Good. Hitting a spot that isn't defended.
Sorry.
Good idea. No problem. It is for the sake of training. Also, do not worry. You were not in any kind of danger. I made sure that the dangerous blades were not active.
I see. Regardless, it's quite strong. I don't think I could push that off even if I tried.
Which is why the best course of action is dodge or move away. Now, there's always the chance that someone might be bigger than you. And being bigger always means stronger. With Ozul at your side, that may be different. But in the case Ozul might be taken away or concentrate in another matter. That's when you have to rely on your own wits. What would you do against a long-range attack?
I guess the only thing I could do is dodge or try to find some other cover in the environment, but that wouldn't work depending on the range.
Would you like an example?
I don't see why not. I need all the help I can get.
I'm gonna destroy this menu. Or this controller,
yeah,
actually.
Fuck that menu.
I'll count to three and then strike. Ready?
Yep.
One, two, three, strike. Remember, counterattack. Don't let your enemy put pressure on you. Strike in 3, 2,
one. Counterattack? I don't know if I ever counterattacked for that.
Remember, I am striking you from the distance. What is the main ability? that. I don't mind a few bruises. Ready. 3, 2, 1.
So I just...
Let the enemy overwhelm you. Learning how to use a blade is useful, but if your field is electricity or magic, do not let someone overpower you in that manner, even if it means dealing slight damage to the ones around. Sometimes, more than not, it's going to
be
helpful. Obviously, make sure you are aware of your surroundings. If someone's injured next to you, doing it would be a bad idea.
Mm. Yeah, that's a good point. Alright, I'll remember that.
Mm. We can train before you have to go, if you like.
If you would spare the time, that would be nice.
Of course.
Thank you, Akume.
Would you like help in something?
No. I honestly just came over to see how she was doing. Did you get any sword training in?
Yeah, I did. I learned quite a few good things from Akume.
Awesome. Feeling confident then?
More confident than I was before, at least.
Oh, that's good. Honestly, despite all the fancy tricks, the main thing to remember is the pointy end goes into the bad guy.
Something like that.
Well. I shall go have a look around town, and depending on what's going on, I'll decide if I should go rest or my night shift.
Alright, sounds good.
Good luck.
Hi.
I think we'll be alright. So, when were we actually going on the mission again?
I don't know.
Okay. That is one piece of information that does seem to have passed by.
One of the guild leaders might be in the hall. We could go ask.
Yeah, it might be good to actually probably quickly ask them. You see, it was a long walk.
Well, how terrifying. Again.
Yeah. Hey, just a quick question. Did, at any point during the speech, either of you catch when we're actually doing the mission?
I was not part of the meeting.
I think you said it was soon, right? Like a couple days or whatever?
Okay. Uh-huh. Just to know if we were, like, getting ready to go in, like, an hour or...
No, I don't think it's today.
I've been informed
that the location of the camp is not yet known. which appears to be a problem that they will sort tonight, one way or another.
I thought Flora had gotten the location from one of the ones that were imprisoned last night, but I'm not sure.
Maybe. Or perhaps she had not reported it to the guild master of the...
Or maybe they're just like looking at a map to figure out whether that's actually where they live or not, you know?
Mm-hmm. It's fair enough.
I don't know. Could be lots of things.
Nishka's already trying every weapon, isn't she?
Yeah. Well, you gotta try lots of things. Hammer wasn't my first idea.
I don't want to do it if people are looking.
I'm sorry,
no,
I did not mean to draw attention.
Watch. It's fine.
Yeah, well, I'm packed. I'm gonna get some tea. Happy training to you.
Thank you. Enjoy your tea.
Thanks. Everything is too small.
Well, there was that blacksmith guy. I don't remember his name, but like, he was a person, and he could probably make you bigger ones.
I have not seen him in a few days, actually.
Oh. Well, maybe he'll show up again, you know? Or maybe one of the other villagers knows someone.
Or maybe everyone's hiding after the bandit attacks.
Could be.
How are you feeling about the mission?
We can do it. Can we get gold if we do it? So we gotta do it.
Go towards your beach.
Down by a beach.
Well, one mission at a time, I suppose. Maybe they could slip on those, as silly as it sounds. How many of those can you make at a single given moment?
Three, four.
I'm just gonna guess a lot. Yeah, you didn't have to count them.
I did hear that Flora apparently got the location of the bandit encampment from one of the bandits. Apparently.
Surely.
Yeah, I don't know. It sounds like she didn't tell you.
I'll speak with Wolfric about it to see if he's aware, and if not, then we'll go seek out Flora to find out this information. We do know that, Akume is aware, but these brigands, these bandits, they carry an artifact of some kind, of some power. Now, I'm not sure exactly what they speak of, they have not described it properly yet. But, if it does happen to come upon you all, I wanted to make it clear that it may become a tertiary objective to seek out where this artifact may be, and collect it. It should be not in the hands of someone that is uncertain.
Righty, so everyone, we got visitors. This is Pike over here on the right, and that's Spike over on the left. You probably are acquainted. Anyways, they're out and about, and we thought it'd be a nifty idea to show them a little bit of what guild members got when it comes to what we do here, our training and stuff like that. They're just going to sit in on your guys' training exercises for the time being. Make sure to show them lots of cool stuff.
Show them the gun. Why are you raising your hand? Just fucking talk.
He burned my armor yesterday, and
I think he should compensate me.
Compensate? Oh, let me see. What happened with it? Is this the armor you're wearing?
Yeah, he burnt like part of it, like with his weird light fire.
Oh my god!
What is this, like burnished iron?
We cannot move back, Gabi. Also,
that is one of us.
Are you okay,
Gabi?
I mean, it's I took it off of someone.
Yeah.
You know.
I see.
Right. I'm just gonna starts like messing with it, like putty.
I will not hurt you,
even though it's metal.
Faith asked me to show them some kind of.
Have this other arm. Hold this other arm like that,
I'll
so I can see.
Try to show at least the least ability. But that they won't report anything.
Yeah.
Right. Okay.
Understood.
It looks the same.
Or at least what.
Well, I don't think they're going to be let go before.
To establish some sort of presence.
Head out.
Yeah, we came in here to make the town cool. This place needs like a total changeover. It's got like way too many problems. It's way too lame.
Yeah.
And like at the end of the day, we were pretty much told to. So.
Right. Well, first, Gabe, why don't you show them a little bit of your range tactic with your light magic?
Well, it wasn't like our idea,
sure.
So I don't feel right taking the credit.
Maybe
for it.
Let's take a little bit of a look over here, Spike Pike.
You'll
why don't
start
you
to
look over that direction?
Huh?
Yeah.
Do it. Gail's right. Gonna
so
shoot off a little thing.
You might want
to.
So
the really handsome
just
guy
as a
with the eye patch.
General warning.
To be honest, I have to get told the rules of like, the
worse
ideas he says twice over because when he starts talking, I stop listening. It's
could
really
I
hard to focus when I stare at him.
Buster!
Oh my god.
Right.
Good work.
That's gotta
well,
be illegal.
Nice form.
That is not.
We're trying to get rid of rules. There's no illegal idiot. Magic.
Okay, never mind. That's true. That's absolutely legal. Or
so you seek to have a world without rules.
Yeah.
In the state of anarchy, like our boss says, might makes right.
Might makes right, huh?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Really?
Well, if you got,
it's
if
coming
you
from humans hiding in the forest.
And you're wrong.
Yeah, that's usually how it works at the camp.
Shut up, that's not how it works. We got tortured, remember, idiot.
Oh, that's true. Wait, no, yeah, you're right. That's
but
cheating.
But right, isn't it?
Torture.
Star.
Light.
There's no cheating,
torture.
Light.
There's no cheating
light.
If there's no rules. What?
That's... don't think...
I would imagine you would not want to be tortured. Yes.
No.
In the world of light makes right. You simply do it with a little finger.
Man, just sit tight for a second, I got some.
If you boiled alive, it would not matter, because there are no rules in place to set some sort of consequence with this action.
I'm gonna have to get back to you on that. I don't know. I'll think of a good argument. Just give me, like, 10 minutes.
Right, lay it on me.
Well, I have a good argument for
I could,
you.
Yes,
take
help
time.
When it comes
them.
To might makes right.
If they
you
are
realize that
tired,
you would probably be at the bottom of the totem pole.
Trust me, it won't.
Yeah,
actually
that's why we
hurt,
listen to our boss.
It will.
Also,
be.
Isn't might
and
is right
the boss correct?
A rule.
Right. Hold tight. See if we can pull
it
off.
Yes.
It's a bit of a fallacy in our perspective. Like
it's kind of like. I don't know if it'd be a rule, it's just more of common sense. Because if you don't listen to the boss, well...
That's true, that's true.
You know.
He would beat you up if you don't listen to him. So we listen to him. He doesn't beat us up.
Yeah, but there's a lot more of you though, right? Like...
Well, I mean, when... Never mind.
It's like...
The United Lights against the singular one is much more powerful.
There's like at least more than five of us.
Still shut the fuck up! Stop!
Terrifying.
Stop talking!
Hmm.
Sorry. If I may, it appears you guys said you've been tortured, correct?
Yep, by...
Yeah, they've been, complaining about it all morning.
He smashed my hand, and then that wing lady electrocuted me, like, six times.
Tired, correct?
I mean, we'd slept all night in a cell with no food, so, yeah.
Would you
have you
like
eaten some?
Hand to
yes, I have.
The kitchen?
On a bed. It was, like, really good, surprisingly.
Oh, yeah, we went, wait, what? Yeah, we ate.
Yeah, probably.
It was a taste of our hospitality.
I mean, she's been another taste of the hospitality. As boy, where'd she go? Where'd the lady with the wings go?
She's left. Celine departed.
She left a while ago. She dropped you off and then just fucked off.
Yeah, that's not
fun. Your situational awareness leaves much to be desired.
I'm confused as to why.
Your name was Spike?
I'm Pike. That's Spike. He took my name. Because he's a copycat.
Hi, I'm Ginny. Nice to meet you.
Hi, Ginny. It's nice to meet you. I like your boots.
Thank you.
You shut the fuck up. You're the one that's been, selling shit this whole time. I've been good.
Pike, you just gave a compliment. I thought you said that you're getting on Spike for that.
Shit! Damn it!
Well, see, it looks like
I'm
you're taking
up your
a
bad
thing
habits.
Out of Spike's book. I thought you were supposed to be taking stuff out of the boss's book.
We've been way too far from the bandit camp.
Is your boss
if you're
really strong?
Is he pretty damn strong? I'd say he's really strong.
But just in comparison to you, then.
That what makes him attractive.
Our
boss? Know any magic?
Yeah.
One person, a lot of people.
No, the guy with the
eye
patch
can take you on.
I don't think our real boss, but the guy with the artifact
is
the real
boss.
As long as you don't cheat with your light show.
But the guy with the eye patch is the hot one.
Yeah,
how can I cheat if
he's really dreamy?
Tell me about it. What's the eye patch?
Different,
it's black, and he's got blonde hair that falls perfectly over it, like a small little waterfall. And then he talks, and I stop listening, and it's just
I feel like I'm bad, but I don't think I have much of a choice.
I think
you
never talked to me a couple
times.
But...
hair.
All right, I'll help.
Yeah,
exactly.
What the fuck?
This is unnecessary.
You are okay.
We're back to escalate then.
I don't feel okay.
He's in a good hand.
It's just.
Yep. You stay away from me. Stop getting closer.
Sorry.
You know, in the process of doing that, you proceeded to back up into two others of us.
Okay.
Oh, him.
Yeah, that's fine.
Sorry, I'm not gonna let him hurt you.
He's crazy. He's a psychopath.
Alright.
That's okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Alright.
I found the sword in the shed.
What are you doing?
He found that sword in the shed.
He was with us a couple days ago when we came here before we were captured. And he ran off, but I doubt he did it because he's a coward or anything, because he's really brave.
Star. Light. Breaker.
And,
so he probably just went to regroup with the rest of your forces and stuff, right? He wouldn't run away.
No way he'd leave us. He's he wouldn't leave us behind.
Definitely.
No, absolutely not. No.
You'd be a fighter.
No, it's
Star, Light, Breaker.
You know, I'm not entirely sure. I don't get to go around the battleground too much. They call me, a long word that I don't entirely understand. It's, incompetent or something.
Yeah.
So, I'm not allowed in the battleground areas.
Scare tactics
that
the other members of the guild are currently using. Would you be so kind as
to
step in? I don't think this is going to result in anything of use.
Yeah.
I'm feeling a bit unsure of myself. If I may,
I think they put him up on a pillar and then shot a beam of light.
Our magics around me.
That's what I saw.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what that
we have.
Of course.
I don't get
I mean,
it.
I'm gonna be honest.
Maybe I should do that too then, with my magic, right?
I mean,
I just said to avoid
I think he's had enough.
I'm agreeing with Guy. I'm agreeing with this guy right here. This is your leader, right? You listen
to him.
Yeah,
he's kind of a big
dummy. Pretty
smart. You okay?
Oh, yeah.
He's not. Yeah, I'm fine.
Of course he
is. You're good. What would you do with the whole group? You're the smart one. Are you the strategist?
Like, I'll voice my opinion a lot, but it's not, like, asked for.
You know. Some people don't understand what they have in front of them, you know? Like.
Exactly. She's smart. She's really smart.
It seems like they're. Boss.
You're not
okay.
Compared to anyone smart. Yeah, I'm Spike.
Hi, I'm Ginny. Nice to meet you.
Calling it.
Not the trick, I promise. I'm not gonna let him hurt you.
Well, to contest.
Of course. Then I will see you at the place. The day of your departure. Good night.
Do you know if there's a reason why we're not giving them over to the town?
My understanding is that if we're going to go deal with them, it's best that we gather as much information as we can before they're taken by the authorities.
Well, you can thank Anna for that idea. Well, Pauline, breaking their nose and electrocuting them doesn't get anyone anywhere. It gets them a lot of ways. It gets more information out of them.
No,
don't you agree?
Do stuff like that, they'll just tell you whatever you want to hear. Even if they don't know anything,
yeah,
they'll
but
make
you
false information to get you to stop.
But you know, they actually had more information. So if I had tortured them a little bit more, they actually could have gotten more information out of them.
It still doesn't make it right for them. We're supposed to be better than them.
So many conflicting opinions.
Trying to do good, and they are not trying to do good.
Is torture good? Is torture honorable?
It will get them the information. Get the information out of them. They're breaking
I'd
the spirit.
I'd rather not have
away.
The information than you have to resort to something like that.
Mm-hmm. don't know what you're talking about, Gail. We can get a lot of information out of someone getting tortured. Because I know.
Just because you can doesn't mean you should.
You guys know the difference between interrogation questions now and, like, regular questions, which is what we're doing now. We're just, like, talking. This is how talking works.
You seem like nice people. I just want to meet you more. You know, like, I can stop. I don't need to ask more questions. Or I can, like, come by and we'll just chat later.
Yeah.
They are nice, but they're also assholes.
And their food is really good. They beat you up because you're being dumb. I told you I'm not gonna get hanged because I'm cool.
You do know that after this is all done, we're going to be getting over, giving you over to the authorities, right?
Yeah, why are we answering?
No,
I told you he's dumb.
Yeah, you know,
helpful.
But you seem pretty smart. So
in
like,
any way,
you know.
And it's not funny.
Thank you.
Look, I'm sure that it's something we can work
very
out, right?
Funny.
Like, I mean, it's just.
Why is it funny to ruin
everyone
every chance to get any ounce of information
and,
out of
know.
Them?
Yeah.
You can get a lot of information out of them to do other things.
Are y'all going to kill my brother?
I don't think so.
No. We simply asked that you simply do not try to run.
It's just Gail and Pierce. They're dramatic types. When they like chase someone down, they gotta draw their weapons and like, but they don't mean any harm.
Is that like something all adventure guild like adventurers do, or?
Some do. Everyone got
okay,
a different
so you
style
know, like,
of it too.
There's probably like the one guy in the Liberators, right?
Wolfric.
Who's always like showing off with a sword and he's actually not good at all with it. Like
Spike
that,
with your
you know?
Sword.
Yeah, Spike. Like
or
Spike. Oh, hi. You're the nice lady
you.
That like healed my wounds. Yeah. I like her.
Bora's really
I
nice.
See your brother is
finally
you're
the one that waterboarded me.
From what I've been informed.
What the
like
fuck happened while
an
I was in the fucking
you,
library?
Not an ish
what?
Me.
A day.
That's a good one. I like that. Can I use that?
See, yeah, cool people use it. I told you my lingo is gonna get popular.
Issue, not issue.
I'm glad you're alive, too.
Good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Are you?
Actually, yeah. I didn't want
Excuse
to put you to the fucking die.
That's the birth of burp. Other
you don't know, I was the one that stopped Goblin from going for you after one. You know, after you lost
a
one
bit,
of that.
Maybe.
Is, so.
But like, you know,
I
mean, he's all
for that.
Okay, sure.
Guys, I came here to pick up my weapon again. I'm gonna leave you guys to deal with it. Don't
right.
cause trouble, I guess.
Bye.
I'll do the trouble for you.
They're not causing any trouble. We're just chatting, having a nice time.
Also, you know, like, how earlier you said in the jail cell, if we said anything, we got back to the boss, we'd get super, like, fucking killed. We said a lot of stuff.
Fuck you, Jessica. You weren't the one getting hurt.
Fuck you, Brian!
What the fuck?
Jessica and Brian?
Your name's Brian.
Did I hear that correctly?
You prefer Pike?
I do prefer Pike, yeah.
Pike
and I assume you prefer Spike, yes?
Thank you.
I do prefer Spike.
Then we will continue to use these names.
I'm Everyone gets to call themselves things. I call myself Jenny. Genevieve is a terrible
name. He calls himself Gabi, and I am almost positive that is not his real name.
Thank you.
Hi, Gabi.
Well, he doesn't know his real name, does he? Or does he remember now? He sort of just showed up a couple days ago.
Pretty sure it's Gabi.
He's pretty sure it's Gabi.
Remove the weapons from him. He is crazy.
You know, it's an ongoing discussion. It's like there's some politics involved, and you know, but sometimes it's because he's a goblin, you know.
No.
I am a goblin.
You are a goblin.
Well, you've seen him.
Are you sure you're a goblin, though?
No. It's kind of like.
Could you just be
maybe
a really short orc, or maybe a green gnome?
If you'll grab a second bundle of rope with me.
Okay.
Just a bundle of rope.
I'm assuming they're in these boxes?
Yes. Here's a bundle of rope.
Is there a rope around here?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Wonderful. I would take it out there.
I'll take this.
Thank you.
You can move much faster than me.
Alright, hands out. I shall need you to cut this. Hands out in front. Together. Not right. Can you cut it?
I got him.
Thank you. Well, now.
Walk. To town.
To the port. Ilya, can you stay on his left side, perhaps?
Spick told me to grab a second bundle of rope. I don't know what you guys need this one for, though.
I have it. It's all good.
I don't know. I didn't hear anything. I was downstairs.
Did they get him?
Did you get there? Where was it? No.
Bandits. We've been having problems with.
I'm gonna go figure out what that gunshot was and come back. We'll
see.
Oh, this is not safe. I should have stayed in my room.
What's going on? I'm very confused.
I saw one of the people in yellow armor run across, and then there was, I think, Gale, who then shot a gun at him, and then a couple other people started chasing after him. More bandits, something? Wait, are they? What? I don't. It was ringing still.
Okay. I think I know who you're talking about. Wonderful. Very wonderful.
Hey, have you seen Gale?
No, I was actually just about to look for him.
So apparently they heard a gunshot and now he's missing, so...
Trading rounds, perhaps?
little fun.
Well, quite frankly, I don't know what's going on, so...
Do you know what the procedure is for being under attack? Do I stay in my house? Do I go to the guild? Do I run?
I don't know. I'm assuming just find somewhere that you believe is safest for you?
I'm going to hope that my home is safe, then. And hopefully no one busts down the door or breaks through the window, and... yeah.
Be careful, please.
Did something happen?
I guess there were two people that weren't really supposed to be here. I don't know. I just came out of my room and everyone's freaking out.
What's going
on? Remember the one in the yellow and the one with the hat-shaped head?
Mm-hmm.
The other bandits we captured previously confirmed that they were actually part of their gang. They were probably undercover to try to break them out. When we found out, we were going to pretend that we were going to give them an excursion to the town and getting there. Nope. We're gonna pretend to give an excursion to the port.
Gale, I'm assuming.
Pretending to the VIPs as training. The one with the pirate attire decided to blurt it out that we should tie their fucking hands together as part of the training. They got suspicious and put a smoke bomb and ran away. We managed to capture one, the other got away, the one in yellow. You don't think it was a good idea to out loudly try to convince them to let us tie their hands as part of a training exercise, but alas. The other one probably got away in that direction to the veil. He's either gonna die or return to his group and inform the others that we are up against them. Hey, Jenny, did you manage to catch him?
Yeah, couldn't find him. Anyone heard anything?
So, looking for a runaway.
The one in the yellow, yes.
You mind if I borrow that?
I'll keep looking.
One day you're gonna have to get your own.
I'll see if I can catch up. I'll be back.
Don't kill him.
He's gonna kill.
He's not. He learned his lesson. Badly injured him, probably, but not killed.
Maybe. Can I talk to you?
Yes, Melody, I was planning to talk to you as well.
Gale. Where's Gale? Have you found him?
No, can't find anyone.
Have you gone up the mountain?
I started that way. I didn't go all the way up.
Might be worth a check. I think everyone's been around town, so.
Alright. Oh.
Please be careful.
Careful is my middle name, Ophelia.
Is it now?
No. Should be. Well, maybe not. It wouldn't be very fitting. Any of your mana today?
Not very much of it. Why?
Just curious. I'm a bit limited at the moment, and if we do run into trouble, well, don't think I'd be much help.
Right. I mean, you've got that fancy dagger. Is that worth anything?
Maybe a little. Do anything too bad, but maybe, I don't know, maybe I look intimidating.
Were they armed?
Oh.
Hi.
Them.
Hey.
Nobody came back with another group.
The footprints were over there, but we lost sight of them, but we can't go any further.
Let's get back to the guild.
Good try, Rez.
So how many was in the initial attack?
There was worth a check. Found about everyone else.
I mean, it wasn't wrong, but...
No, it wasn't.
Different blonde one, I presume, because the other one had an eye patch.
We'll have to be careful with the one in armor. He broke through his ropes in his cell.
So there were three the other day.
Three the other day, including the two that we have in the prison right now, and then two more just now today. Five of their group that has shown their faces, and three of which they don't have any more.
Thank you.
got away?
I think it was generally believed, but it wasn't confirmed yet.
I see.